Traveler's Guide to Medieval England is unlike any other history book I've ever read. It's like a legit tour guide. It starts off in the English town of Exeter, on this little bridge called Shitsbrook. It's called Shitsbrook because people toss their shit into the river, like the creek below. It smells awful. After he takes you through the town, he goes over all interesting bits about England at this time. Like, you're gonna learn how money works, how fashion works, all the little social activities that are common at the time. You're gonna learn just about how unhappy this century is for Europe. He talks a lot about Geoffrey Chaucer, mostly because Geoffrey Chaucer's accounts are seen as very good insight into how English people lived at the time and like what the social norms were. You learn about the laws, you learn about the social classes, you learn about various plagues that happened throughout this time, all the flooding and whatnot. England floods a lot, and it is very hard to farm there from time to time. It goes all through the 14th century, which is the century that housed the Black Death. So you already know how that went. But it is also the century that housed King Edward III, who, through this book, I have found out is the most badass king to ever rule England. Go ahead and argue with me. Like, since I play a lot of D&D, like, now my own world that I'm creating, when I've got players that I'm DMing for in that world, they don't get maps. But something I found out is maps were not used for travel until, like, the 15th century, the late 15th century. They were merely used for reference. You rarely ever see one. It'd be like one in maybe a castle somewhere, but you didn't have maps. You had to ask directions. You had to know places. You get to a big city, and then you can't be out past dark unless you are well known and you're carrying a lantern. Other than that, if the watch finds you, your ass is going to spend the night in the Tower of London. If you're in London, you'd spend a night in jail anywhere else, though. Murder rate was insanely high. Theft was punishable by death. You're a man, you hang. You're a woman, you drown. I also found out one of the most fascinating things, that domestic violence was solved way better in the medieval times than it is now. True, you could hit your wife in medieval times. It wasn't even frowned upon. But she could always go to the church and say, "He beats me too often, he beats me too hard," and your ass has to go off to some monastery or friary somewhere so that you can become a formed man. And you will, because your ass is going to be subject to poverty, chastity, and obedience. Like, he even goes over what people thought was funny back then. Like, what was funny in another time is not funny now. You would be so surprised how, like, people's taste in comedy changes based on their culture. Not until this book that I actually, like, had some sort of pride in my English heritage, you know? Me being an American and whatnot. Because, like, we don't really think about that. And, like, being English here is, like, my favorite flavor of ice cream is vanilla. My favorite color is blue. My favorite food is pizza. You know, it's not anything interesting. Now it is, though, because English history is awesome. Now I am motivated to learn how to fire a longbow, which has a 70-pound pole and uses a 3-foot-long arrow and is 6 feet tall. Guess where I learned that? So if you're interested in medieval history, this is a wonderful book to pick up. I guarantee you.